Hey guys, want to wish you guys a happy new year. I'm going to go over the program for the week of January 6th through 12th. This is finally our first normal week, so back to normal schedule throughout. Hopefully you guys are going to get back into your normal routines, and I will see your smiling faces at the gym lots this week. So we're going to start Monday off with back squat testing. So we're going to do a squat cycle, and it'll be really important for me and you to know what your one rep maxes are. So Monday we're going to test our one rep max back squat, and then go for part B, a 14 minute AMRAP of dumbbell single arm hang clean and jerks, single arm overhead lunges, as well as box jumps. Good old fashioned cotton allergy workout for the 5 a.m. crew. They're celebrating something again. It'll be a fun workout. Tuesday, we've got split jerk instruction and practice, and then you're going to do some percentage work with the split jerk. If you've never done split jerk or haven't tested your one rep max in a long time, you can also build to a heavy split jerk for part B on Tuesday so that you have a better idea of where you're at when it comes to what you can lift with the split jerk. Part C, pretty high skill conditioning set for Tuesday. We have muscle-ups, handstand push-ups, and double unders. So don't feel bad if you can literally not do any of those moves. You can absolutely scale. We're scaling muscle-ups to ring rows for everybody. Handstand push-ups to dumbbell seated press, and then the double unders, of course, double under attempts or single unders there. For Wednesday, we're going to practice some toes to bar. Again, pretty common goal for a bunch of you for 2020, and then we'll do some conditioning with running and more toes to bar. Thursday, working on pull-ups. Again, another common goal for you guys, some sort of pulling movement has been definitely seen a lot and heard a lot as far as when I ask you what you guys want to get better at. So we're going to do some pull-up negatives, banded PVC lat pull-downs, and then some hollow holds just to get you in a better position and getting those lats firing for the pull-ups. And then we'll go into an alternating EMOM with rowing, deadlifts, and plank hold. Friday, we've got Monster Mash yet again. Each part, just like last week, has a barbell, and those barbell weights change. Ultimately, the power snatch and the shoulder to overhead both should be fairly light for you. That shouldn't be a heavy or even a moderate weight. You should be able to kind of churn through those reps when it comes to those lighter barbells. However, the squat clean is supposed to be pretty heavy, but again, there is a sweet spot there, so don't go too heavy on the squat cleans on Friday. Saturday, partner workout where you share 100 reps with a partner, and then you both run together and you come back in, do 100 more reps of something else. I won't really tell you what all those fun movements are, but it does involve empty bar thrusters, which are very, they're tougher than you think they'd be. And then finally, Sunday, we've got some hang power snatch. If you are looking to get better at Olympic lifting, I typically program some sort of Olympic lifting on Tuesdays and Sundays, and then of course we have our Olympic weightlifting classes with Margaret. Those are great times to start really focusing on the skill of Olympic lifting. Super high skill barbell stuff, it can be super frustrating. I've been in the sport for 10 years and I still don't have that great of Olympic lifts. So don't get too frustrated, but if it is something that you feel like you want to work on, Tuesday and Sunday, those Olympic lifting classes, but also the workouts that involve it are good times to try to get better at it. Part C, we got an AMRAP on Sunday with air squats, burpees, and some more hang power snatches. So first full week back from vacation, so it's time to basically start focusing in on your goals, and let's get after them this week.